It's time to review Ubuntu 19.10 and see what new features Ubuntu 19.10 brings. Hey folks, I'm Abhishek from It's Boss and I'm excited about the new Ubuntu 19.10 release. What about you? Are you excited about this new release? Leave a comment yes if you are looking forward to Ubuntu 19.10. So let's see what's new in this one. As you can see, it looks quite visually appealing to the eyes, especially if you are coming from Ubuntu 18.04. The visual changes are plenty. The Yahoo theme has been polished. At least they look good to eyes. Don't you agree? If you have used Ubuntu 19.04, you won't notice a lot of difference here. But this is the stepping stone for the next LTS release, Ubuntu 20.04. So the features you see here, they should also be included in Ubuntu 20.04. Ubuntu 19.04 uses GNOME 3.34, and that brings a lot of features that GNOME 3.34 has introduced. Let's talk about the new features. The first and foremost thing you will notice is the background settings or the wallpapers. And I'm not talking about the new wallpapers. I accept that the wallpapers look good, especially this one. Oh, it's a magnificent looking wallpaper, but I like this other one better. So what's new here is that you can set the background and the lock screen, and you can see all the wallpapers in one place. And you can also add your own wallpapers right from this setting here. And the good thing is, when you add something, you can see all those additional wallpapers in the background settings itself. It wasn't the case before. And the good thing is that if you delete the wallpapers, like downloaded wallpapers, from its original location, it will still be available in the background settings. If you think that there are too many wallpapers, additional wallpapers, you can remove it from the settings. Another change is the introduction of the Yahoo dark theme. So the default theme is a combination of both light and the dark theme, but you can change it to complete dark theme. And you can see it looks really good. And if you are a dark theme fan, you will love it. All the GNOME specific applications or the applications that use GTK, they comply very well to the dark theme. But you may notice that not all applications, you know, change to the dark theme, especially the web browsers where you can do nothing when, well, the web page is with white background. It's not just the dark theme. Yahoo also has a light theme, which I'm not really a fan of, because it changes the border of the application window to a light theme, which looks like classic GNOME. Ubuntu initially thought of making this Yahoo light the default theme. I'm glad they changed their mind, because, well, it's not really that good looking to be the default theme. Don't you agree? There's also a subtle change in the Nightlight feature. So if you go in the display, Nightlight has its own tab now, and you can change the things from here. You can change the setting from here, like from automatic to manual schedule. What I did notice is that even though the location services are turned off, the Nightlight works. And if I'm not wrong, you need to have the location services turned off to use the Nightlight feature. At least that was the case in previous versions. Ubuntu 19.10 also has smoother scrolling and animation. There's a new feature which is grouping of applications, like what you do on Android and iOS smartphones. So what you can do is, you can group same type of applications together. Like I grouped these office icons together. You cannot change the name of the folder though. It automatically gives an appropriate name. GNOME 3.34 is supposed to have improved performance and better memory management. As you can see on my Intel NUC, it has 1.5 GB of RAM consumption when there is only one additional application running, that is Chasm, for recording this screen. Apart from that, I haven't noticed any out of the world performance improvement or any decrease in the performance for that matter. There are also some under the hood changes, like a faster boot with LJet 4 compression. I tried to run systemd analyze and I did notice a little bit of faster boot in Ubuntu 19.10 compared to 18.04. Apart from that, Ubuntu 19.10 has promised experimental ZFS file system, but I did not see that option while installing 19.10. There's kernel 5.3 and other under the hood changes. That's all I could notice in Ubuntu 19.10 so far. If you're using Ubuntu 19.10 and you notice something else, do let me know in the comments. And if you have any questions about using 19.10 or upgrading or any other generic question, do let me know in the comments below and I'll try to answer them. If you like this video, do give it a thumbs up. And if you're new here, do subscribe for more Ubuntu and more Linux related stuff. Bye bye for now.